All the blaze lies, empty hearts, buying happy from shopping carts. Nothing but time to kill, sipping high from bottles.
Hi guys, it's James. I'm sorry I've been absent for a few days. I've been super sick, but I'm finally feeling a little bit better despite the fact that I still can't breathe out of both my nostrils. But you know what? We're gonna make it work. I figured I'd do a foundation and base routine today just so it'll be easier later on when I make more videos so I can just link them all back to here instead of having to do the same thing every single time. If you want to know how to recreate this everyday makeup look and foundation base, make sure to keep on watching. I'm starting off by priming my face using my Benefit Pore Professional Primer. It's literally my favorite primer of all time, and it smooths out my skin so much, which is great because I have a million bumps, and I'm a teenager who gets pimples and blackheads and all sorts of gross things on my face, so. For my foundation base today, I'm going to be using my Makeup Forever Ultra HD Foundation in the shade Y255. I'm just going to be applying it with my Beauty Blender and creating little dots all over my face. Normally I would color correct my face before this, but I just shaved this morning and I got a decent amount of sleep last night, so not feeling too blue today, so I guess we're just going to go right in. Now normally I'd go in with my concealer, but a few days ago I accidentally used my Client foundation on my under eyes as a concealer, and it actually worked so well, so today I'm going to be using my L'Oreal True Match in the shade... N1 under my eyes to highlight today. As you can see, that just provided me with a really nice under eye highlight, and it doesn't look super crusty and gross, and it's not really creasing either, so maybe I'll start using this more often. Now that we look like Casper the Friendly Ghost, I'm gonna go ahead and set my entire face using my Coty Airspun powder. This powder is so good, and it's a really nice alternative to the Laura Mercier powder, and it's literally like $7 from Walmart, so definitely would recommend. Now I'm going in with my Morphe E48 brush. It's just a really nice tapered powder brush, and I'm going to pack this light shade under my eyes to further highlight. To contour today, I'm going to go in with my Benefit Hoola bronzer. It says James's Hoola on it. How freaking cute is that? Benefit has the best packaging, I swear. So to contour my face today, I'm going to be using my Morphe M523 brush. I'm also just going in to contour and bronze my forehead because it's humongous, so it'll appear smaller, hopefully, fingers crossed. Now to warm up my contour a little bit more, I'm going to be going in with Makeup Geek Cocoa Bear. My cheekbones are very high up, so I don't really have enough room in my face for contour, blush, and highlighter, so I usually just skip out on the blush. I don't really like how it looks on me. This really helps to warm it up and make me not look dead. Now I'm just going to go back in with my Coty Airspun powder and a powder puff just to bake my contour so I can get a really nice defined line. While I'm baking in the oven at 350, I'm going to zoom you guys in so we can do our brows together. I'm using my Morphe B74 and my Anastasia Dip Brow in the shade Soft Brown. I'm going to start in the middle of my brow and just start drawing little flickety lines. Once I get to the tail, I'm just going to do a little flick. Same thing again with the top. I'm just starting in the middle of my brow rather than the front. I'm going to connect those two lines. And once again with the excess product, I'm just going back in and defining the inner corner. Okay, yes, I realize these brow clips are at an absolutely horrible angle. I'm really sorry. I'm still trying to figure out how to do this whole thing. Please just bear with me. I promise I'm coming out with a full brow tutorial soon, so stay tuned. Now that I have the basic shape, I'm going to go in with my LA Girl Pro Concealer and a flat definer brush just to carve them out. And once I have the bottom of that brow carved out, I'm just going to go ahead and blend it down so there isn't a super harsh line. Once we have that all done, I'm going to go in with my Anastasia Tinted Brow Gel in the shade Espresso, just to set all my brow hairs in place so they don't go flying throughout the day. And that, guys, is a finished brow. I'm going to go ahead and do the other one off camera, then we can continue with the rest of the face. Now that I finished my brows, I'm just going to go ahead and wipe off my bake with my Morphe E34 brush. And that just leaves it really defined and nice, so it's not a straight line, but it's cut. I'm not going to do any eyeshadow with this just because this is my base tutorial and I'll be doing eyeshadow looks with this later on, obviously, but I'm gonna go with my mascara. I'm gonna be using Benefit Roller Lash today. It's my Holy Grail mascara. For my highlight today, I'm gonna be using my Anastasia Glow Kit in That Glow. I'm gonna be dipping into the shade Dripping in Gold. I'm gonna spritz my brush with just some Benefit Hydrating Mist. When you wet your brush before doing your highlighter, it makes it super vibrant and intense, so helpful hint. I'm just highlighting my nose bridge and Cupid's bow as well. For my lips today, I think I'm gonna go in with Ofra Pasadena. It's just a really nice nude shade. Obviously, I will change this depending on what look I'm doing, but for an everyday look, it's super wearable. I do have a coupon code with Ofra too. If you use the code JCHARLES at checkout, you'll get 30% off. You're welcome. And that, guys, is the finished look. This is just a really good everyday makeup look, but it's also my base routine. It's what I do for all my looks, aside from the lips and eyeshadow, obviously. But if you wanna ever create any of my looks, this is what you should start off with. You guys have all been asking me how I do my fake freckles as well, so stay tuned on Thursday. I'll be uploading a video tutorial on how to do them. It'll be super easy and quick, but hopefully it'll help you guys out. If you guys did enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up down below and subscribe if you haven't already. If you recreate this, make sure to tag me on Instagram at JCHARLESBEAUTY, and my social media links are also down below. I'll see you guys soon with another video. Bye!